That's for deadlines. Time control, we're looking for control, you can't get control. Relationships, people, information, intermediary, interdependencies, control. All the time we're trying to get control of what's going on. We're not talking about control outside, we're talking about control inside. We're talking about controlling what we deal with, not us controlling other people. It's just making sure we control what's going on to us. Quite comfortable with that? Yeah? Information, knowledge, competitive advantage. Again, power from knowing information is important, and control of information. Management. Management's job is to direct events. Okay, so the three here don't have anybody working for them, but directing events and directing people is what they do. Yeah, if Eileen can direct her clients in the way that suits her best, sales, she will then be able to do all the things she wants to do. Yeah. And editors who can give a slot there or send a photographer down or whatever. So the whole time, although structurally you have nobody working for you, you are constantly directing events, directing people. Okay? Obviously on this side, you've got people. You've got, you know, in a sense, Wendy's got the steward above, but she's also got the Janets below. Okay? And it applies both ways. Okay? Effectively inspire. That's what management is about. Yeah? If you can persuade people, yeah, to go further than they would otherwise have gone without realizing they've gone. In other words, if you can persuade them to do that, yeah, but happily do that because somehow it's giving them all of this, and even down to here, self-esteem, self-respect, belief in themselves, etc., etc., reason for all these type of so-called airy-fairy stuff by doing that. That is, in effect, an element of brilliant management. You're in the middle. We have time, which we've said just goes tick, 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 doesn't change, 24 hours. And we have actions. Now, your actions vary between must-dos and as and whens. When you start the day off, you've got 10 must-dos. But as the day starts unrolling, things happen to those must-dos. You get incoming fire that change the priority of those actual must-dos. So the meeting we're going to have with John, John's phoned in to say he's running 3 hours late. Can we arrange the meeting for this afternoon? So suddenly I've got 3 more hours to do my must-do for John, okay? Other times things come in, they've got nothing to do with John, but in the light of that, I've actually got to contact John and renegotiate. Like, I'm really sorry, John, I know we're going to have this meeting in the morning. Can we put it off to the afternoon because I've got to do this, this, and this? Again, another piece of incoming fire. All the time, your must-dos, your as and whens are changing. The key to them changing, and this is one of the fundamental reasons why traditional time management systems don't work with their prioritizing, their A's, B's, C's, the D's, E's, the reds, greens, blues, the ones, twos, threes, the different boxes, urgent, important, important, urgent, all those type of things don't work is because they don't take into account the constant changing of priorities, of information, which in effect affects your priorities. So your actions are constantly doing that. We've already established the as and whens is infinitum. Yeah, there's no end of as and whens. Because we gave you 6 months, at the end of 6 months, you still haven't done all your as and whens. I can't take time out for myself unless I'm confident I've earned the right to, that I'm not letting anybody else down. Time thing is another one, but I'm always late. If you think about it, if you're late to a meeting, what does it actually say to the person you're late to? Yeah. I had better things to do in my time. I pushed it to the limit and I overstepped it. I'm sorry. If I said to you, turn up on time and I'll give you £1 million, you'd turn up on time, wouldn't you? Yeah? But because I'm not giving you £1 million, brackets, you know, you're not that bothered if you're a little bit late for me, then you've turned up late. So if someone does it to you, it's rudeness. It's straightforward rudeness. I'm aware of that. I'm absolutely constantly aware of it. And unfortunately, because again, in terms of efficiency, you are pushing it to the limit the whole time.